Hi there, thank you so much for joining me today. This video is going to be an impromptu declutter video. I have 13 products here that I just don't want in my collection anymore, kind of in that spring cleaning kind of mode, so I thought I would go individually into each product and why I want to either pass them on to a loved one or just straight up throw them in the garbage. It's pretty self-explanatory, so I'll get started. The very first two, I think people would be very surprised because I'm getting rid of two blushes. Those are typically the hardest for me to declutter. I love collecting blushes and having lots of different colors. The blushes and highlighters, I don't mind having more of. So the first one is from Marc Jacobs, and it's the Air Blush in the shade 500 Lush and Libido. And this is one that's got like stripes on it, and if you concentrate on one half, you can get a lighter color and then a deeper color. And I do think these are really good quality blushes. This is just something I don't ever reach for. I do think the colors are pretty. I need to have very specific looks to wear this with, and it's just sitting in my collection and getting older and older when somebody could be enjoying this more than I am. So this is getting passed on. The other one is another shade that I don't reach for. It's the Cabana Boy blush from The Balm. I think these are fantastic blushes, especially if you can get them for half off during The Balm sales. I definitely think they are worth the money. And you get a ton of uses. I think the Frat Boy blush, I eventually hit pan on that one, and it took me over 200 uses just to hit pan. So it's definitely something that is a good value for your money. It's one of the most affordable cost per use blushes I've ever experienced in my lifetime, and it really just is the color. It's just not something I'm gonna reach for. Both of these are really pretty purple shades. They're kind of plummy, and these are blushes that I really loved a few years ago, but in the last 2 years, my preferences for blushes have really changed. My preferences for colors, at least. I like to go for more natural blushes, more blushes that don't look like much in the pan, but then when you put them on your cheeks, they look really nice. I don't really go for the bright purple plums anymore like I used to, and they are just not going to get loved in my collection, so I'm gonna pass them on. Another one here is from NYX. It's a highlighter. It's the Born to Glow highlighter in the shade Stand Your Ground. I believe there are two different shade options in this, and I saw Tara Babies on YouTube. She swatched this in a haul a while ago. The texture isn't really anything to write home about. It's a little bit powdery, it's a little bit dry looking. It's not like a baked gelée formula or something. It is pretty when you work it into the skin, but it's just not a formula that I love. And on top of that, it has gold glitter in it. I've been wearing it every day for the past couple of days, and it really just leaves gold sparkles on my face. The reason I did buy this is because I thought it would be a nice alternative to the Becca Berlin Girl Glow highlighter, because it is a little bit more of like a cool toned champagne-y shade, and I thought it would be similar. It's not at all. I don't like the formula. I would reach for pretty much any other highlighter in my collection over this one, so I'm gonna pass it on. Now let's talk about some eyeshadows. The first one, you'll probably won't be surprised to see that I'm decluttering. It's the Stila Jade Duo, and I had originally chosen this in a Panda's Eyeshadows project, and I chose this shade right here, and I did hit pan on it, but you can't see the pan anymore because the product just really disintegrates. Like, I don't really know how to explain the formula. The formula of both of these are really bad, but really different. They're bad in their own ways. This one on, I guess that would be your right, is like, it just hits hard pan immediately. Like, I'll put my finger in it and it'll just turn straight into hard pan. And I've tried using tape, I've tried using all these different ways to get the hard pan to go away, but every time I dip my brush or my finger into it, it hard pans again, so it's really hard to get any pigment onto my eyeball. That's a really pretty color. If I could get that on my eye, I would keep it, but I can't. And the other side is incredibly flaky. It's just like a super crumbly, powdery formula. And the color is really pretty, but every time I applied it, no matter how I applied it, there would just be glitter all over my cheeks throughout the day. It just didn't stay in place, and it's just not worth the hassle. I have since found other green eyeshadows that I like. I would like to explore more formulas. I know a lot of companies are coming out with their own green shadows, green pigments, green palettes. I don't need to keep this in my collection. I use my Ulta points to get it, so it's not like I spent the 20-something dollars right out of my pocket, but I did use my points on it, and I'm just gonna get rid of this. It's not good. The other shadows I wanna talk about are singles. This first one here is Fireball by Urban Decay. It's a little mini. It was a sample single that I got forever ago before I even owned a Z palette or any kind of magnetic palette to put this in. And it is a really pretty color. It's like an orangey pink with a really hot pink shift. It's a very interesting color. It's not something I ever enjoy wearing. Anytime I try to put on my lids, I just don't really like the way it looks. I think that hot pink shift is just not something I like on myself personally, so I'm gonna pass this on. Another one here is a single from Stellazzi. It's in the shade MS27, I believe. I put a little magnet on the back so I can't see the name of the shade anymore. This was just a free single that I got during IMATS. I think I gave Stellazzi my email address and they gave me a free single. And it's a really pretty color. It doesn't look as orange on the eyes. It pulls very yellow. And I have an abundance of yellow shadows, more than I could ever possibly get to. I don't use yellow eyeshadow enough to warrant having so many. So I'm going to pass this on. Same with this shade here. This is Tiki from ColourPop. Really good formula. I have nothing but good things to say about the ColourPop formula, especially considering the price. But once again, I have so many yellow eyeshadows. I have one more single yellow shadow from NYX that I'm trying to hit pan on in my Panless Eyeshadows project. And then I have another one, Paper Tiger. It's not super yellow. It's kind of more of like a mustard yellow, but it's still in the yellow family. And then I have some yellows that I have in palettes as well. So I just don't need Tiki. It's a very primary bright yellow, and I just don't need that. Last one here is After Party by NYX. It's a single. The formula of this is not good. It's very patchy. It doesn't really pull green when you put it on your eyes. It pulls very grayish brown, so it doesn't really have the color payoff that I would want it to have. And I have other olives that I prefer, so I'm gonna pass this on as well. Let's move on to some lip products for a little bit. I have a Catrice lip balm, and this is in the shade Delightful Lips. I have the shades Beautiful Lips and Graceful Lips, and these are fantastic. I've actually almost used up an entire Beautiful Lips balm. This is a fresh one, and I rave about this. I think it's fantastic. I recently purchased some of the other shades to try because I saw that they expanded their collection. This one in the shade Graceful Lips is what I'm wearing today. It's just a really pretty nudie peachy color. I do enjoy both of these. I like the formula, I like the price. This one, however, in the shade Delightful Lips, this one has shimmer in it. It's a shimmery look, and it gives you more of like a metallic balmy look, and I know my mom really loves that type of look. She loves putting shimmery shadows on her lips to kind of add a little bit of something there, so I'm going to give this to her while it's fresh. It's just not something I'm going to reach for often enough to warrant having, and I know she'll like it much more than me, so I'm going to pass that on. One here that unfortunately expired, this is from Lipstick Queen. It's the Frog Prince lipstick. It's the one that is dark green and then it turns into a plummy pink on your lips. I accidentally purchased this during an Ulta sale thinking it was a cruelty-free brand. It's not, and I went to grab for this recently because I figured I'll just finish it and then not buy it again. When I went back to reach for it again, I realized that the smell had changed dramatically. It doesn't smell great anymore. I don't want it anywhere near my mouth, so this is going in the trash, unfortunately. Another lip pencil here. This is from NYX. Wow, I have four NYX products in here. Normally I love NYX, but some of their stuff is very touch and go. This next one is a NYX lip pencil. This is the Slide On Glide On formula. It's my favorite lip pencil formula for the most part. I recently purchased this green color in Revolution, and the formula was incredibly dry. I talked about this and swatched it in my recent beauty regrets video, beauty products I regretted buying. And this one, the formula is so different from the other lip pencils from this brand. It's not even salvageable. I keep sharpening it. I keep doing all these different things to try to bring the formula back, and it's just not good. It's incredibly patchy. It's gotten to a point where when I try to swatch it on the back of my hand, literally nothing shows up. So this, once again, is also going in the garbage. My last NYX product is a lip scrub. It's from the hashtag ThisIsEverything line. I have both the lip balm, which you guys know I absolutely adore, and I also have the lip oil, which I think is just okay. And this is the lip scrub, and normally I don't really care too much about different lip scrubs. I do have a lip scrub from Wet n Wild coming in the mail, but for the most part, I don't really use lip scrubs on a regular basis. This smells really nice, and it's a white scrub with pink sparkles in it. The pink sparkles in there stay behind after you remove the scrub, and it has a very like thick, waxy type of feel that it leaves on your lips. So if the scrub gets anywhere outside of your lip line, you're gonna have waxy feeling all over your skin. I don't want that on my skin. I imagine that's clogging my pores like crazy, and it's also got glitter in it, which I don't really understand why people put glitter in skincare products, but whatever. So every time I use this, there is just a huge waxy, balmy feeling all over the bottom of my face. Plus, there is glitter everywhere that's impossible to get off. And it's just not something I'm comfortable using anymore. So this is going. And the very last one here is a bronzer from Physicians Formula. This is the Bronze Booster in the shade Light to Medium. And I've used this enough to actually have hit pan on it, which is not a small feat. This took forever to hit pan on, and I wish I had started tracking uses by the time I started using this. I bought this forever ago. This is probably 4 years old at this point, and I'm not anywhere near finishing it. And when it comes to my bronzers, those are very workhorse type products for me, and I buy bronzers with the intention of eventually finishing them. And I just don't see myself wanting to finish this, especially using it over other bronzers in my collection. Something about the color is just slightly off to me. I think it just pulls a really orange on my skin tone. I don't know if you're gonna be able to see in this lighting, but it just pulls incredibly orange on my skin tone. It doesn't look like a natural bronze for me. And so it is something that I'm going to pass on. It's just not worth using up for me. So that means it's not worth keeping. So those are all of my products. I don't typically get super negative in my videos, but sometimes I just have a lot of things to say about a lot of different products. Let me know if you're decluttering anything in your collection that you just don't want in your collection anymore. You open your drawers and you're just like, why are you still here? But in the meantime, that's everything I have. Thank you so much for joining me, and I'll see you in my next video. Bye, guys.